Hey guys, welcome back to another video. This is the Rockland Boulders versus the New York Brave. If you don't know, the All-American Baseball Challenge consists basically three teams, but really six teams. Three teams split up into two groups each. Normally on Thursdays, for the most part anyway, they kind of play themselves, and then the rest of the weekend they have a series against an actual other team. But this was a Thursday night, so the two teams that Rockland has are the Rockland Boulders and the New York Brave. Still an exciting game, though. Trust me, this is an exciting game, especially toward the end. It got wild. Of course, 400 fans. Actually, I don't know the exact number for New York State, but it seemed to be around the same, if not the same. I would guess 400 fans, probably. But yeah, got some stuff at the end, not a lot, but I did get at least one thing, from the stadium, afterward as well. So other than that, really enjoy the video.
Ball challenge tournament first round contest between the New Jersey Jackals and your Rockland Boulders. And batting ninth, the designated hitter, number 34. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask that you please rise if you are able and kindly remove your caps. 19 years ago, our nation and the greater global community suffered unspeakable tragedy when terrorist hijackers with hate in their hearts and evil thoughts in their heads attacked both the World Trade Center in New York and the Pentagon in Virginia with passenger airplanes. Another attack, which was to take place in Washington, D.C., did not make it to its intended target thanks to the passengers on board United Flight 93, who bravely fought their hijackers and forced their aircraft down in a field in Pennsylvania, sacrificing their lives for countless others. Please join the All-American Baseball Challenge, the Rockland Boulders, and the New Jersey Jackals as we remember those civilians, first responders, and military personnel, including 81 members of our Rockland County family, who lost their lives in New York, Virginia, and Pennsylvania on September 11, 2001. We also remember those who have passed away since 9/11 from illnesses related to the attacks and subsequent recovery. We pay tribute to all of them, as we honor a pledge made 19 years ago, we shall never forget. And now, please join us as we observe a moment of silence. Thank you. And now please remain standing for the play of our national anthem.
About 68.
All right, there we go. Yeah, I see that.
Well, no, they got a wholesaler, but they just find where it falls. Nothing printed. That's still a ball you can mark straight from the playoff game, too. Mm-hmm.
Today's final line score for the New Jersey Jackals, 11 runs on 16 hits with no errors. For your Rockland Boulders, 2 runs on 4 hits with 2 errors. The winning pitcher for the New Jersey Jackals, Pete Jones. The losing pitcher for the Rockland Boulders, Ben Hoffman. Time of the game, 3 hours and 27 minutes.
Okay, so this is everything gotten from the Rockland Boulders versus New Jersey Jackals Friday afternoon playoff game from Friday, September 11th, 2020. Of course, I kind of already put everything away. Not that I forgot about this part of the video, but I just, you know, it was just easier for me to put everything away. And it was, you know, I'm just lazy, so I didn't feel like fully bringing everything out. So, and really all we have, this is the reason why I'm making this video. Let's be honest. If I did not have that, this part of the video would not exist because there'd be really nothing to show. This is just your standard printed ticket. They didn't even know who they were playing or which team the home team would be playing at the time that they made this, to be determined at Boulders/Brave. Obviously now we know it was Jackals and Boulders at Palisades Park, 1 p.m. Section 109, general admission. You had the Boulder Bird mascot. You have regular season champions, 2015, 14-15. And yeah, that's it. There was no parking either. They weren't charging for parking this time. They still had the standard $5 parking last time I went, but I guess, you know, Friday afternoon, you know, 1 o'clock, showing up around 12:30, they had no one to work the parking, so it was free. And this is my first Frontier League ball. Just happened to be in one of the stands. You can see in the video clearly how empty it was, so it wasn't hard to get. And actually, you can barely make out Frontier League, but it is Frontier League, so hey, I'm going to count that. Yeah, I haven't gone to Frontier League ball. Obviously, it's always been a Midwest league. I'm obviously on the East Coast. These three teams, Rockland, New Jersey, and Sussex, were supposed to go to Frontier League this year. But obviously that didn't happen, won't happen till at least next year now. And obviously they had some balls already for some reason. But that works out for me because now I have a Frontier League ball, even though I've never been to a Frontier League game. And I didn't just drop that. But anyway, you can see the scuffing right there, definitely where it was hit. This might have been hit a couple times. Rawlings is less scratched off than Frontier League, and then you see your normal dirt and stuff. You see this big dent. This was not from a bat, for sure. They would have thrown this out. This has to be... It bounced off of something with a sharp edge, I gotta imagine. And that's what created this. I can't tell you what created this exactly, but it's definitely not a bat. This bounced off somewhere on the concourse or a seat or something. Something with an edge that made it do that. See a little bit, it's kind of hard to see on camera here, but you see a tiny bit more scuffing here. Then the rest is just mud and stuff. Can't exactly tell what this says, but I assume it's not much. It's just, it probably just says where it's made and stuff. I forget what it usually says here, but it's not usually anything important. Usually the important stuff is the league, important to me anyway, official ball, Frontier League, then you have the commissioner signature down below. So that's really cool. First Frontier League ball. And if you also have watched my videos, you know that I usually mark these up. Like I have, I forget what it's called, but kind of like I type up these labels and then put them on the ball. So I know exactly like who hit it, you know, what part of the game, what game it was, the date and all that. That's what I do to these balls. I haven't done this with this yet because like I said, this was a ball that was found. So I wasn't paying attention when, you know, what batter hit this. All I know is that it was bottom of the eighth, most likely, that this was hit. I have to look through my footage. Hopefully, I can determine, you know, based off of the direction of where the ball was hit. Somewhere, I'm hoping that somewhere in my footage, I can kind of narrow it down to who hit this ball, and then I can label it up. So, but anyway, that's it for this part of the video. Thanks for watching, and I will see you all later.